All right, so the original tutorial that I made in 2019 on how to export a GIF with a transparent background from Adobe After Effects has more than 350,000 views on YouTube. So it seems like a lot of people had the same issue that I did back then. However, many people in the comments have let me know that the solution doesn't really work anymore, and me being a super, super nice guy and someone who literally sells GIFs for a living, I decided to make a new and updated tutorial on how to fix that solution now in 2022, so let's get straight to it. Alright, so here we are in Adobe After Effects, and I assume you already have a composition or a video or something that you want to export as a GIF with a transparent background. In our case, we just have this cute little stock animation of Santa Claus taking a selfie with a selfie stick. Maybe he needs some new sick photos for his Tinder profile. I don't know. But we're just going to use this awesome, cute stock animation for our tutorial. So first things first, unfortunately, this is still not possible to do directly from Adobe After Effects. Not even Media Encoder can do this. They can export GIF, but not with a transparent background. So we gotta use a bit of a workaround using Photoshop. But step number one is you export this composition from Adobe After Effects as a transparent video. So for settings, you make sure you select format QuickTime. For channels, super important, you need to have RGB plus alpha. And for format options, make sure you select Apple ProRes 4444. Okay, click OK. And I'm just gonna export this on my desktop and render real quick. All right, now it's time to open this up in Adobe Photoshop. So let me just see what I can do here. I'm just gonna drag and drop it into Photoshop here. And as you can see, we have this new panel here on the bottom for timeline, because this is literally a sequence of frames. And now let's basically convert this MOV file into GIF. So to do that, you just go to File here on the top left, Export, and Save for Web or Legacy. And this is going to load pretty, pretty slow, so give it some time. Doesn't matter how fast your computer is. But the GIF format, fun fact, is literally around 32 years old, I believe. So the latest release was in 1989, which makes the GIF format literally older than I am, which is crazy to think about. Anyway, so here we are, and there's a couple of settings that you need to know here. So I'm just gonna walk you through all of them right now. Super important, if file size or bandwidth or whatever is important for you, this is the approximate file size of the export. So if 6 megabytes is fine for you, then that's perfectly cool. If not, you can kind of reduce that a little bit by reducing the image size. So the resolution, for example, here, or just as percentage. So I'm just gonna make it 50%. And again, this is gonna take forever to load. But as you can see, now it's at 3.7 megabytes, which is already better. And if that's still too much, then you can kind of play around with the colors, for example. The GIF format is very limited and only allows for a maximum of 256 colors. But in this case, I don't know, we only have a couple, so maybe we can just take it down to, I don't know, let's say 16. The quality might suffer a little bit, but as you can see, we took that even further down to 1.8 megabytes. But in our case, it doesn't really matter, so I'm just gonna go back to the full quality. All right, so super, super important, and actually the main reason you're watching this tutorial, you wanna make sure you have transparency turned on, right? In which case the background is gonna be transparent, as you can see here. Also, super important is you wanna make sure here where it says animation, you have it set to forever. So it's gonna keep playing and looping forever. Otherwise, if you select it at once, which has happened to me multiple times by accident, it's gonna play once and that's about it. And now this is where we get to the tricky part, which is something called matte. And the description here says defines color to blend transparent pixels against. So I will also give you a couple of examples later. I will fast forward, but just hear me out real quick. This is basically if you know exactly how you're going to use this GIF, so for example, if you use it against a white background on a website or banner or whatever, then you want to make sure you select matte white. What this is going to do is it's going to optimize the edges to work super, super well and blend smoothly against the white background. So the edges are going to be very nice, very good quality and work well on a white background. But if you use the same file against a black background, for example, you might see a little bit of an edge around it. And the same is true if you want to use it against a black background or select something else. There's also an option to select none, in which case it will work well against all backgrounds. This is the advantage. But the disadvantage with matte none is that the edges are going to be a little bit rough. And I'm just going to fast forward this a little bit later and show you a couple of different renders just so you can see the difference a little bit better. All right, so now let's go ahead and click save and save this on the desktop. Again, it's going to take a couple of seconds, regardless of how fast or slow your computer is. All right, and now let's go to our desktop and see what happens here with this file. So I'm just going to right-click, open with, and I'm just going to open this up with Safari, but obviously it works the same in all browsers. And here we have it. This is how you export a transparent GIF from Adobe After Effects. All right, so I exported a couple of different settings just to show you how the math works. So the first one here on the left, if we zoom in a little bit, you're going to be able to see that the edges are a little bit rough, right? But, you know, then again, this is a format and a compression system that's more than 30 years old. The latest release was in 1989. So honestly, I wasn't even around back then, so I'm impressed that it can even handle this, no matter how bad it looks. But then we have the one in the middle, which has a white mat. And I don't know how well you can see on YouTube, but the edges, so this one on the right, the edges are a little bit smoother than this one here on the left with no mat. So this works super well against the white background. However, if we go here on the right, and we're using the same version as here in the middle, so white mat here on the right as well, and as you can see, the edges are a little bit white when you use it against a dark background. So that's pretty much how the matte works. It's an unfortunate limitation of the GIF format, but it's something you gotta keep in mind and navigate carefully. For most use cases, I would just recommend you export with a white matte, and that's pretty much it, and try to use it on a white background. All right, so this was the tutorial on how to export a transparent GIF image from After Effects. I'm Edward Stinger from videoplasty.com. And before you go, I just want to show you our website, videoplasty.com, where we have some awesome stock animations, stock GIFs, and vectors. And yeah, have a look around, see if you find anything that you like. We got a lot of super funny characters. We got a white Santa, black Santa, tens, hundreds of characters, icons, animations, and anything that you want. We got 3D stuff as well, stuff that you can just put together and make an awesome little video. And yeah, we also got GIF files as well, actually. So if you want to spice up your presentations, yeah, have a look, see if you like anything. We got all different races possible, black, Indian, Asian, white, and so on. We got Arab characters as well. We got icons, everything that you want. We have it here, right? And if we don't, just send us some suggestions and we'll see what we can do. All right, I hope you enjoyed this video. Again, I'm Edward Stinger from videoplasty.com. Make sure to smash the like button and leave a comment below. Let me know what you think. And yeah, make sure to subscribe to my channel for more awesome tutorials. And until next time, stay creative.